Welcome to my channel. Please subscribe my channel Nursing Now Easy. Like this video and share this video. Today's topic is self-adaptation. Self-adaptation means the changes taking place in a cell. Changes taking place in a cell in response to environmental changes. Environmental changes. What are the environmental changes? It's the internal environment or external environment. Any changes taking place in a cell by means of external stimuli is called self-adaptations. The normal functioning of cell. The cell is some functions are characterized by or conducted by the cells. These functions are altered by the environmental factors or chemical agents, any disease conditions or stress within the body. Stress is all are alter the cell function. Although are yet to be the survives this cell along with this any stress or any changes, the cells survives and continues their functions, continues the function. By means of small alterations or small adaptations, this is called as cell adaptations. This is called as cell adaptation. Any environmental factors or any hazards alter the function of the cell, the cells yet to be function by means of adaptation is called cellular adaptations. In cellular adaptations, mainly five types: atrophy, hypertrophy, third one, hyperplasia. Fourth one, dysplasia. Fifth one, metaplasia. Five types: atrophy, hypertrophy, hyperplasia, dysplasia, and metaplasia. Atrophy means the decrease in size of a cell. The size of a cell is normal is like this. It leads to decreased size of a cell. It's called atrophy. In atrophy, two types: pathological atrophy, and physiological atrophy. In pathological atrophy, it is commonly seen in skeletal muscles and cardiac muscles. And physiological atrophy is commonly seen in thymus is atrophy in childhood. And tonsils atrophy in adolescence. Physiological means common phenomenon and pathological means any disease conditions leads to atrophy. Next, we go to the hypertrophy. Hypertrophy means increase in size of a cell. It is a reverse of the atrophy. It is an increase in size of, it's a normal cell. It's an increase in size of a cell due to any environmental or any conditions. In hypertrophy, three types. First one is physiological, compensatory. In physiological means what? Physiological, especially in exercise, leads to the increase or hypertrophy of the muscles, skeletal muscles, or ventricles of the heart, cardiac muscles, due to the increased exercise or increased workload. In pathological condition, it's pathological means any disease conditions or pathological changes leads to increased size of the cell. Means, example, ventricular hypertrophy on the condition of hypertension. In hypertension condition, ventricles are hypertrophized. It's a pathological condition. In compensatory means, any one organ or fails to function. Means in kidney, the kidneys are two organs. In case any one kidney fails to function, the other kidney or hypertrophized to compensate the function or to overcome the dysfunction of the other kidney. Or any in case the one arm or dysfunction, one arm is dysfunction, the other arm are stronger, means of hypertrophy. Next we move to the hyperplasia. It is an increase in number of cells, means the cell is one, it is an increase in number of cells called hyperplasia. Hyperplasia means increase in number of cells. It is also in three types of hyperplasia. First one is physiological plasia, third one is compensatory hyperplasia. Physiological hyperplasia, pathological hyperplasia, and compensatory hyperplasia. In physiological hyperplasia, the proliferative phase of the menstrual cycle, means the cells of the menstrual in the proliferative phase increases their numbers. And pathological hyperplasia, it's a common physiological phenomenon. And pathological conditions means any disease conditions. In this, due to any increased hormonal secretion, increased growth hormone secretion leads to the gignatism. Increased growth hormone secretion leads to the gignatism by means of hyperplasia of the cells. And compensatory hyperplasia, especially seen in liver cells are epithelial cells. In liver cells, the damaged part, that in case liver means damaged part, is surgically removed by the any after surgery, the removed part, the liver cells are removed. The other normal cells are hyperplaced or cell divided and forms the or regenerate the liver. Next we move to the dysplasia. Dysplasia is the abnormal changes in size of the cell or shape of the cell or organization of the cell. It is not differentiated in cell adaptations, but it's changes taking place in shape. That's why consider cell adaptation. Means it is abnormal changes in shape, size or organization of the cells is called dysplasia. And it is commonly seen in epithelial cells, cervix and respiratory tract. Next we move to the metaplasia is the condition that involves replacement of one type of cell. It's a normal cell. Replaced by another type of cell is called metaplasia. The replacement of one type of cell with another type of cell. Metaplasia also two types mean physiological metaplasia, pathological. Physiological metaplasia and pathological metaplasia. In physiological metaplasia, example, transformation of cartilage into bone. Transformation of monocyte into macrophages. Pathological metaplasia is an irreversible condition. Pathological means irreversible condition. In chronic smoking cases, the ciliated columnar epithelial cells of the respiratory tract. Are replaced by the non-ciliated squamous epithelial cells. The ciliated columnar epithelial cells of the respiratory tract are replaced by the non-ciliated squamous epithelial cells in the chronic smoking cases in pathological conditions. These are all the five types of cellular adaptations: atrophy, hypertrophy, hyperplasia, dysplasia, and metaplasia. Please subscribe my channel Nursing Now Easy and like this video and share this video.